Hi guys, welcome back to Rama tutorial for English classes. In today's class, we are going to learn about pronouns and their usage. I think you remember, in last class, we have learnt about pronouns and their kinds. In today's class, we are going to learn about pronouns and their usage. And it's very, very important that you learn and practice these rules, which will help you to solve some of the problems related to spotting error, sentence completion and close test. I hope this will help you a lot. And if you have any doubts and queries, please comment in the comment box, or you may use our WhatsApp box also. Okay, let's move and learn. Here is the first, look at the first two examples. What do you see? Each girl must bring their books. Do you agree? Both examples are correct. Okay. In next sentence, every man must wear their mask. See here, every man must wear their mask. Each girl must bring their books. I think you have noticed that both examples, the above examples, are incorrect. You see here, each girl must bring their books. The problem is here, like this. Here, the pronoun. This pronoun must agree to the subject it is referring. But here it is not using that. And every man must wear their mask. Here also it is not referring to the subject. So, both are incorrect. Let's see what are correct. A pronoun must agree with its antecedent in person, number and gender. A pronoun must agree. Here, this pronoun is not agreeing with its antecedent. Antecedent means subject it referring. And here also this pronoun is not agreeing with the antecedent here. Okay. In person. Person means first person, second person, third person. It must agree with that. In number, if it is referring. Here, every man is singular, but it is plural. Right? It's a plural pronoun. And here, each girl is also a singular noun. But here in this example, you can see it's a plural pronoun. So, these two examples doesn't comply with the rule of the grammar. That's why both are incorrect. Right? Then, the correct form of that, each girl must bring her books. Here, we are referring girl, a single girl. Okay? Each girl must bring her. Here, it is agreeing with the subject, its antecedent. It is agreeing with the antecedent, so it's right. Every man must wear his mask. Every man is a masculine gender. It is referring masculine gender. And here we are using a pronoun which is also masculine gender. Every man must wear his mask. All students, it's a plural subject. Plural subject. So, must do their homework. Our students must do their homework. Here also, it is agreeing with the antecedent. This is the rule. It's time for us to learn the second rule. Okay, let's learn about the second rule. Let's look at the examples first. One must finish his task. One must obey his elders. Here, we are using pronouns one. And these two examples are not following one rule, one simple rule, that whenever we use a pronoun, especially if it is one, it must take ones. The rule says that if you are using the pronoun one, it should follow with ones. Okay? So, these two examples are not following that. You see, here one is taking his, which is wrong. Here also, it is taking his, which is also wrong. What is the right way? here you say we can write it like this. Let me rub this and put it back. One must finish one's task, right? One must finish one's task. One must obey one's elders. This is the right way of doing that. Okay, let's take the third rule in a row. He resigned from the post. Look at this example. There is a small mistake, but I think you cannot decode it, I hope. She absented from the class. Here also there is a small mistake. What is that? The rule. Let's go to the rule. Rule says that whenever you use the verbs like resign, absent, acquit, drive, exert, avail, pride, apply, you have to use reflexive pronoun when they are used as transitive verbs. When they are used as transitive verbs, you have to, what you have to do? You have to use reflexive pronoun. For example, she absented her from the class. You have to, she absented herself from the class. Here you see, I have used herself as a reflexive pronoun. You can't say she absented from the class straight away. You have to say she absented herself from the class. इस तरीके से आप क्या कर सकते हैं, इसके ठीक तरीके को समझ सकते हैं एग्जाम्पल के द्वारा. अब हम आगे चलेंगे. गाइज, लेट्स मूव टू फिफ्थ रूल. बिफोर लर्निंग अबाउट रूल, लेट्स टेक द एग्जाम्पल्स. रेडी? Whom do you think lost the match? See here, whom do you think lost the match? Who are you chatting with? When you see both examples, you might have felt that there are slight mistakes. You are right. Have you noticed them? No? It's very important. In spotting error test, you need to spot the errors, right? Whom do you think lost the match? Here, you see here, whom do you think lost the match? When we see this example, we feel that here we should have used who. Now you read it out. Who do you think lost the match? Next, whom are you chatting with? Here in the first sentence, it's referring to the subject. Who do you think lost the match? Here the answer comes, India lost the match to Aussies. Whom are you chatting with? I'm chatting with my girlfriend. If you answer like that, it means that who denotes the subject. Whom is used for objects. But in earlier case, I made that thing. We were able to learn that who is used for subject, whom is used for object. Here, who is referring to the subject of the sentence, whom is referring to the object of the sentence. So, in that case, earlier there was a mistake, now we corrected. And you always follow this rule that whenever you use who, it should denote the subject, not the object. Vice versa, whom should refer to the object. Let's take another one. Either Geeta or Sita will give their notes. Neither Geeta nor Sita has done their homework. When you see here, either or, they are correlative conjunction. They always, either always follows or. Neither always follows nor. Okay? Both they work together. Either or, neither nor. These two subjects, either Geeta or Sita will give their notes. It means that, sentence means that either one of them, either here and this is Geeta, this is Sita, either of them, one of them will definitely give the notes. This is a positive sentence, which means that वन ऑफ देम, दोनों में एक, तो नोट्स देंगे ही देंगे. When it comes to neither, neither Geeta nor Sita has done their homework. Here you see, neither nor means negative sense. They are used in negative sense. It means that no one, nor Geeta nor Sita, no one will give their homework. No one will do their homework. It means that it is in negative sense. This is in positive sense. But here you see, there is a slight mistake. Either Geeta or Sita will give their. There is a problem with that pronoun. We should use singular pronoun there, but we have used a plural because Geeta is singular subject, which is singular, and Sita is also a subject too, which is also singular. And if the two subjects are in singular case, they should always follow a singular verb. They should always follow a singular verb. But we are losing that. We haven't got that. So it's very important whenever you use either or neither nor, when they are connected with subjects which are singular, like Geeta, Sita, Geeta, Sita, both are singular subjects, they should always follow a singular pronoun. When two or more singular nouns are joined together by either or, neither nor, the pronoun is singular. You must use a singular pronoun. When the two subjects which are singular are joined with either or, neither nor. I think you have learned this. If you have still need more clarity, I am going to provide. Let's move to there. See here. Let's take the one more example, one more rule number 6. Here it says that either the inspector or his assistants failed in his duty. Neither the inspector nor his assistants failed in his duty. According to rule number 5, you may say that the both examples follow the rule, but there is a slight change. I think you have noticed it. Either the inspector is singular here, or his assistant, which is plural. When a singular subject and a plural subject both are joined using either or neither nor, then the subject, then the pronoun which we are going to use must be plural. Either the inspector or his assistant failed in their duty. It must be in their duty, because here his assistant is plural. Neither the inspector nor his assistant failed in their duty. This is the right way of doing so. Let's take the rule. When a singular subject, the inspector, and a plural noun, his assistants, are connected by or, like here, either or, and neither nor, the pronoun must be plural. Here we have used a plural pronoun. Earlier we have used a singular one, but now we have to use a plural one. This rule demands a plural pronoun. Let's take two more examples and we will learn about rule number 7. Which dress is lying here? Here you see, that's quite easy example. What magazines do you buy? Whose magazine do you buy every month? Here when you follow these examples, there is a small change. That which is used for things and whose is used for persons. And both examples are not following here. Let's replace them. Whose dress is lying here? Now it's understood. which magazine do you buy every month? It means that who's used for persons, which is used for things. Earlier there were mistakes, now they are correct. This is the rule number 7. Who's used for living persons and which is used for non-living things. I think you learned this. Let's move to next problem. Friends, let's take rule number 8. She and him are good friends. Here, example look like very very good one, and you might not find any mistake at all. He and me are twins. What is the mistake in there? My friends, you may be wrong. See here, rule says when two or more pronouns are joined by and, when they are joined by and, what we have to do? We have to use the pronouns in the same case. See here, she is in subjective case, right? He is in subjective case. And we are using and to connect with the another pronoun. But what is the case of these pronouns? Yes, they are in objective case. These are in subjective case, but these are in objective case. That's wrong, my friends. Here, they should be like he, she and he are good friends. He and I are twins. Okay? Whenever you use two pronouns, if they are connected or joined with and, they must be in same case. If they are in subjective case, they must be in subjective case itself. When two or more pronouns are joined, by and remain in the same case. क्या होता है जब दो प्रोनाउन को हम यूज करते हैं साथ साथ में एंड का प्रयोग होता है तो क्या करना आपको दोनों प्रोनाउन को सेम केस में रखना इधर शी सब्जेक्टिव केस में है उसका ही भी सब्जेक्टिव केस में रहना ये रूल उसका अर्थ है लेट्स मूव टू नेक्स्ट एग्जांपल ईच वुमन एंड ईच मैन शुड डू देयर ड्यूटी ऑनेस्टली I don't find any mistake. Do you find any mistake here? Let's take each headmaster and each teacher should sacrifice their souls for the profession. What is wrong in that? But there is wrong, my friends. Here each woman and each man is joined with and. And each is taking a singular noun and here each is taking a singular noun. When two nouns, singular nouns are joined with and they are preceded with each, like this, with each, like this, you have to use a singular pronoun. You should not use a plural pronoun. Then each woman and each man should do their duty, her or his duty. You have to use like this. Each woman and each man like this. You may change each girl. For that, there is a quality of gender also. Each woman and each girl should do her duty honestly. Like, now it's okay. The headmaster, each headmaster and each teacher should sacrifice his soul. Each headmaster and each teacher should sacrifice his soul for the profession. This is right. Whenever each are followed by singular subject, what you have to do? You have to use a singular pronoun. When two singular nouns are joined by and preceded by each and every, the pronoun used for them is singular. Let's move to next problem. And a pretty next
we are going to learn about
rule number 10. A pretty girl like she won't marry him. What is wrong in that? God knows. A teacher like I can't obey them. A teacher like I can't obey them. There is no wrong. It seems like that, but that's not the truth. Here, whenever like is used, when a pronoun comes after like, here she is coming after like, here I is coming after like, or unlike, it takes an objective case. It means that a pretty girl like her, you have to use her, a pretty girl like her won't marry him. Like always takes here of objective case. A teacher like me can't obey them. I think you understood this rule. And let I clean this room. Let I clean this room. Let she go home. See here, there is one problem. Whenever you use let, this structure always demands an objective case, like let me clean this room, let her go home now, let her go home now. A pronoun in the objective case must be used with let structure. I think you understood this point. Okay guys, let's move to next problem. Friends, let's move to rule number 12 or something. 12. Here is an example. You and I must complete your project. You and I must complete your project. Here you see, you is the second person, I is the first person, and they are combined with the connector and must complete your project. In this case, there is a slight mistake is there. What? When second person pronoun and the first person pronoun are used as subjects, here we are using them as subjects. They are playing the role of subjects. The pronoun following that, here that is the, this is the pronoun, must be in the first person plural. See here, we have used a second person plural, but we must use a first person plural. This rule applies when the subject is second person and the first person. And the follow pronoun should be like this. Our, you and I must complete our project. You and I must complete our project, not your project. I think it's clear. Whenever you are using you and I as subject, you must stick the follow-up pronoun to the first person. But this rule changes when you are using second person and the third person pronouns as a subjects. See here, what is happening? We are using third person singular. But what you have to do? You always follow up with a second person plural. Means you and I must complete your project, not his project. When you are using second person and third person, the following pronoun should obey or follow up with the second person, not the third person. So the answer is you and he must complete his project. Following pronoun should be in the second person. I think it's clear. Main aapko samjha deta hoon. Aap second person aur third person dono ko use kar rahe hain ek hi sentence mein. Wo dono subject ke sthan pe hain. आप क्या कर सकते हैं, वो फॉलो जो प्रोनाउन है वो थर्ड पर्सन सिंगुलर में नहीं होने का बगल बदल में वो क्या बनेगा, सेकंड पर्सन प्रोनाउन, यू शुड यूज सेकंड पर्सन प्रोनाउन. बट इन द अबो केस दैट इज रिवर्स, व्हेन यू आर यूजिंग सेकंड पर्सन इन फर्स्ट पर्सन, द फॉलो प्रोनाउन शुड बी इन द फर्स्ट पर्सन प्लूरल. दैट इज द आंसर. लेट्स मूव टू रूल नंबर 14. Here you see, here is an example. Between you and I, either of us cheated her. Between you and I, either of us means you might have cheated her, I might have cheated her. We don't know that. In this case, here between is a preposition, and you and I are used. That you are used together. And here they are following up after preposition, they are used after preposition. In that case, what you have to do? You have to use the follow, this one should be in the objective case. Like this, between you and me, either of us cheated her. The pronoun, the follow pronoun after and should be in the objective case. Like if a pronoun comes after a preposition, it should be in the objective case. You see here, between you, it is also in objective case. Me is also in objective case. Both are in objective case. You can't use both in subjective case. You have to use both of them in objective case. Between you and me, either of us cheated her. This is the rule. Next, the wisest person who ever lived made mistakes. This is related to relative pronouns. Okay. Whenever you are using a superlative degree, like here the wisest person. In the second example, this is the best thing which we can offer you. Here, this is the best thing which we can offer you. Here in the both example, the wisest person is in superlative degree and the best thing is also in superlative degree. In that case, you can't use relative pronouns who and which. Instead of that, what you have to use? You have to use that. Means, when the relative pronoun that is used after superlative adjectives of these kind. क्या होना आपको जब कभी भी आप superlative degree adjectives को use करते हैं उस जगह में who or which जैसे relative pronouns को आप use नहीं कर सकते, बदल में आप क्या करना पड़ता है, that को use करना पड़ता है आपको. This is the relative pronoun that is used after the superlative adjectives. Whenever you are using relative pronouns, you have to stick to that. You can't use who and which. Let's move on. Friends, the last rule which we are going to discuss in today's class is related to relative pronouns. Here is an example. He is the same guy who complained against me last week. Here we are saying he is the same guy who complained against me last week. Here you find no mistakes with that example. Grammatically it's very very accurate, but there is a little difference. I will say she is the only actor who can do this. Here also it is the only actor. This there is no mistake. But whenever you are using relative pronouns who are, whose or which, after only are the same, you have to use that. For example, let me explain you in detail. Whenever the relative pronoun that is used in reference to who or whose, afterwards like are, the same, only, none, nothing, after these words you have to use that. आपको जब जब कभी भी आपको ऐसे एग्जांपल आते हैं आप क्या करना पड़ता है, who, whose के उनके प्रेफरेंस में आपको दैट को यूज करना पड़ता है जब कभी भी सेम हियर इज द सेम गॉय लाइक ओनली शी इज द ओनली एक्टर व्हेनेवर यू फाइंड दीज स्ट्रक्चर दीज फ्रेजेस आपको ऐसे फ्रेजेस मिलते हैं तब आप जॉब के दैट को यूज करना इट इज द सेम केस व्हाट इज देयर व्हिच आई कांट ओपन इट व्हेनेवर यू आर फाइंडिंग एग्जांपल्स व्हिच आर इन इंटरव्यू फॉर्म मींस What is there which I can't open it? There you have to use that. What is there that I can't open it? Friends, up to now we have discussed a lot of things related to pronouns. Especially we have discussed about usage. I hope this class will help you a lot. Please give a thumbs up, give a like and share to your friends.